Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to save the resources in any Android app to SD card. So here this is my Android project in Sketchware, and here I have this image resource called image and on call, and in the same app I have a sound resource called mysteries. So I have the resources image and on call in drawable folder and mysteries in raw folder, which is sound folder. So for saving these, I have this button 1 for saving the image, then button 2 for saving the image on call, and button 3 for saving mysteries. Now first thing which I have done is in on create, I have created a string variable called folder, and here I have set the folder to which I am going to save the resources to get external storage directory. Then I have added this block write string to file path empty. So this is required for adding the write external storage directory permissions in Android manifest file. After this I have added a more block called extra. In this more block extra, first I have closed this more block extra, and after this I have defined a void variable called save resource. So I have defined this method save resource with variable with an int variable resource id and a string variable file name. So this save resource contains following code. First thing is I have defined an input stream for the resource id mentioned here by writing input stream in is equal to get resources dot open raw resource resource id. And in next line I have used this try catch exception block, and here in this try catch exception code I have defined an output stream called out as a new file output stream, new file with folder and file name. So here the string variable folder has already been defined in onCreate method, and the string variable file name will be entered here in this method save resource. So folder has already been defined in onCreate and file name will be written here. So for that file name I have defined a file output stream called out. After this I have defined a byte called buffer as new byte 1024, then I have defined an int len, and then I have used this while loop. While length is equal to in dot read buffer, this in is input stream, dot read buffer comma 0 comma buffer dot length. So while it reads this buffer, and while reading it, if it is not equal to minus 1, I write the buffer to this int len, and in the end I get this. Means I write the complete thing to SD card. Then I close this input stream, I close the output stream, and then I show the message that the file name is saved, and then I close this try method, and after that I write catch file not found exception e, and after this I write catch IO exception E, and for each exception I show the message e.get message. So that's all in coding part. You can find this code in description of the video. Now I am going to use this method called save resource on button click. So here I will be writing save resource, and after this I will write the resource ID of the resource which is to be saved, and then the file name of the file which is to be saved. So when button 1 is clicked, I save the resource r.drawable.image, comma, the name of the file, which it will be portrait.jpg. And when button 3 is clicked, I save the resource r.raw.mysteries with name mysteries.mp3. Now let me show you this app. Here's this app, and when I click on this save button, portrait.jpg is saved to SD card, and when I click on this button 3, mysteries.mp3 saved to SD card. And you can find these files in the SD card. Here are these files, mysteries.mp3. We can play this, and the second file, portrait.jpg. So that's all in this video. I hope this was useful. Thank you very much for watching this.